to Michael Mikhail Gorbachev, whose perestroika opened the windows to this vision of the future in the United States, Eastern Europe, and the Soviet Union. Kali, my wife objected to my doing this because she said, he may be out of office before the book is out. I said, it makes no difference, because what he did by letting the Berlin Wall topple, by letting go to East Germany, Poland, Czechoslovakia, Romania, Hungary, it really is an extraordinary event that he deserves all the world's credit for, because that's going to change the future of Europe. And even if he's out of office, or even if Yeltsin's out of office, no one, their successors are not going to be able to solve the problem of the Soviet Union in this century. To go from a totalitarian state with state capitalism, no private property, no free enterprise, no market economy, to a market economy with private property capitalism is a very difficult job. It's going to take Russia, with all the help the West can give them, the Soviet Union, I think the next 10 or 15 years to make that change. Yeah. It isn't a reform of the Soviet Union. It's really a replacement. They have to replace state capitalism with private property capitalism. They have to replace totalitarian control of the economy with free enterprise and pluralism. Now, that's an extraordinary change. It's going to take a long time to do.
What is, and you do pose the question in the book, what basic mistake in communist socialism and in bourgeois capitalism is the cause for their own destruction?
Well, the words you use are difficult. In fact, one of the things that anyone will learn from reading this book carefully, particularly the first essay, is how badly we in this country, as well as people in Europe, misuse words. There's no conflict between capitalism and communism. That is a mistake. There are two forms of capitalism. What we call capitalism in the West should be called private property, free enterprise, market capitalism. What is called communism what used to be called communism, should be called totalitarian state capitalism, where the state owns all the means of production, operates all the capital wealth of the country. Now, when you understand that, then you understand something else that's very important. Most people in this country, if they learn nothing from this book, they're going to learn this, use socialism as meant the same thing as communism. Yeah. On the contrary, Marx was a socialist before he was a communist. There were various forms of socialism in his day, in the 19th century. In fact, socialism came into being in the 19th century. And he defined communism as a scientific form of socialism, and meant by that the means to achieve the socialist goal. Socialism is an ideal, a goal of economic equality. And he defined communism as the abolition of private property.